Hi everyone, in this video we will look into the challenges related to upper layer in next generation networks. In addition to the unique challenges of XG networks with respect to spectrum sensing, spectrum mobility, spectrum management and spectrum sharing, there are issues in upper layer like routing, low control and congestion control. These are considered to be important for the realization of dynamic spectrum networks. First comes the challenges related to routing. Routing constitutes an important but yet unexplored problem in next generation networks. Particularly in XG networks with multi-hop communication requirements, the exceptional characteristics of the open spectrum phenomenon demands the development of novel routing algorithms. The need for routing algorithm in open spectrum environment constitutes an important topic in XG network research. In this video, I'll give an outline of two existing solutions for routing and discuss on the open research topics in this area. First, a major design choice for routing in XG networks is the collaboration between routing and spectrum management. The dynamic spectrum that is intermittent in terms of both time and space requires such an approach. Next, a cross-layer solution that considers joint route selection and spectrum management is proposed. In this approach, each source node uses DSR, that is dynamic source routing, to find candidate paths and schedules a time and channel for each hop. This source-based routing technique is performed centrally using a global view of the network to show the upper bound in achievable performance. A comparison of layered and cross-layer approach can be made using a novel graph modeling technique, which would reveal that cross-layer approach is advantageous for routing in XG networks because the availability of the spectrum directly affects the end-to-end performance. These solutions for routing in XG networks attest that cross-layer approaches that jointly consider route and spectrum selection is necessary for XG networks. In continuation to it, another unique challenge for routing in next-generation networks are the development tools for analytical evaluation of routing protocols. Traditionally, routing protocols for ad hoc networks are analyzed using graph models. However, in these networks, communication spectrum is fixed and continuous, which is contrary to the dynamic nature of XG networks. Hence, a node can use the same set of static channels for communication with all the neighbors. On contrary to it, modeling network topology and connectivity of XG network is challenging. A layered graph model is proposed for this challenge. In this model, each layer corresponds to a channel in the network. In each layer, each node is represented by subnodes forming the vertex in each layer. This model is exploited to construct routes. Using different cost functions for each edge, required constraints for routes such as interference avoidance can be achieved. This model provides an interesting solution for XG network modeling for relatively static link properties. However, time-varying nature of available links necessitate time-dependent models for a complete analysis of next-generation networks. Here, I try to summarize open research issues for routing in next-generation networks. First comes the common control channel. It has already been emphasized that the lack of a common control channel in next-generation networks constitutes a major problem. Traditional routing protocols require either local or global broadcast messages for specific functionalities such as neighbor discovery, and route establishment. However, even broadcasting in XG networks is a major problem due to the lack of common control channel. Hence, solutions considering this fact are required in next generation networks. Next comes the intermittent connectivity. In XG networks, the reachable neighbors of a node may change rapidly. This is because of two reasons. First, the available spectrum may change or vanish as licensed users exploit the network. Moreover, once a node selects a channel for communication, it is no longer reachable through other channels. As a result of this, the connectivity concept used for wireless network is different in XG networks, and depends on the spectrum. For this reason, channel-based model as well as time-based solutions are required. Next comes rerouting. In XG networks, due to the intermittent connectivity, a route established for a flow can change due to the available spectrum in addition to mobility. Hence, the rerouting algorithms considering the dynamic spectrum is necessary for routing in XG networks. A spectrum-aware routing adapts route selection to spectrum fluctuations. Last comes the queue management. Queue management in XG networks is another challenge which has not been addressed till date. An XG terminal may have multiple interfaces for communication with different nodes. Since the available spectrum varies over time, these interfaces may become unavailable, requiring the packets served through that interface move to other interfaces. In addition, the quality of service requirements may deploy various priorities on different traffic types. Hence, the implementation of a single queue or multiple queues for each traffic type of each interface need to be investigated. Next is the challenges relating to transport layer. Transport protocols constitute an unexplored area for next generation networks, since there exists no work in this area. In recent years, several solutions have been proposed to improve the performance of TCP and UDP in the conventional wireless networks. These studies focus on mechanisms to limit the performance degradation of TCP and UDP that arise because of wireless link errors and access delays. The XG networks impose unique challenges for transport protocols as explained here. The performance of TCP depends on the packet loss probability and the round trip time. Wireless link errors and hence the packet loss probability not only depends on the access technology but also on the frequency in use, interference level and the available bandwidth. Therefore, the wireless TCP and UDP protocols that are designed for existing wireless access technologies cannot be used in dynamic spectrum assignment based next generation networks. On the other hand, round trip time of a TCP connection depends indirectly on the frequency of operation. For example, if the packet error rate, that is the frame error rate, is higher at a particular frequency band, a higher number of link layer retransmissions are required to successfully transport a packet across the wireless channel. Moreover, the wireless channel access delay in next generation networks depends on the operation frequency, the interference level, and the medium access control protocol. These factors influence the round trip time of a TCP connection. Therefore, based on the frequency of operation, round trip time, and packet loss probability observed by a TCP protocol will vary. Hence, transport protocols need to be designed to adapt to these variations. The operation frequency of cognitive radio in next generation networks may vary from time to time due to spectrum handoff. When an XG terminal changes its operating frequency, this results in a finite amount of delay before the new frequency can be operational. This is referred to as the spectrum handoff latency. The spectrum handoff latency can increase the round trip time, which leads to RTO, that is retransmission timeout. Conventional transport protocols can perceive this RTO as a packet loss and invoke its congestion avoidance mechanism, resulting in reduced throughput. To eliminate the adverse effects of spectrum mobility, transport protocols need to be designed in such a way that they are transparent to spectrum handoff. Thank you for watching this video. To get immediately notified whenever I upload a video, kindly click on the subscribe button and press the bell icon. Don't forget to click that like button because that motivates me to post more videos. If you want me to make a video on any specific topic of your interest, kindly let me know in the comment section. Thank you once again.